it's not. I don't think it's nefarious. I think it's benevolent. I think it's basically love. I think the universe is essentially love, and it sounds so like hippie and corny to say it.
Yeah.
But I feel it's true. The universe is love and bliss at every moment, but we're just not fully ready to accept it. So we have all these fears and insecurities, and we keep working through them and having trials and dark moments. That's part of the growth process that we need so that we can become, you know, cosmic citizens or illuminated individuals or I don't know, whatever else is happening.
I totally agree. And I think that's a beautiful way to put it, you know, in regards to that the, and this is also difficult, I think, for you know, people to ponder upon in regards to that a negative experience in itself is not a negative experience, and you don't have to feel down over the fact that you are down, because this is, just as you say, a tremendous opportunity to learn and to grow and to, you know, get over something. And I think you put it beautifully.
Yeah, and then to maybe be able to help the next person who comes along and has the same experience, and maybe your experience will be able to help that person. Because if we're all one, maybe you have to go through something so that you can help another part of yourself. Yeah. Or maybe it's like people who are reflecting on like how if everything is love and bliss, are there things like murder and rape and robbery and all these really dark things? And, you know, if we're all one, then maybe that horrible experience you had is something that you needed to be so that you would be stronger later in your life for some other trial or to help another person. And it's really difficult, and it also, again, it ties into not thinking of things in good and bad.
Exactly, you know, yeah.
In these extremes.
And these
because
are...
Because love, in a way, is not... The opposite of love is not evil or hate or something like that. Love is more unity. It's oneness. It's not... It doesn't really have an opposite. It's... Yeah.
Very interesting. Yeah, and exactly. I totally agree. I think that these, also many of these subjects are so emotionally loaded that people are, you know, almost unable to just, you know, sit around and talk about them for what they actually might be, because they're so quickly, you know, emotionally involved. So just as you say, being able to learn from someone actually being murdered, it's almost like it's a dirty thing. But I think that it's important to view these kinds of things in many different perspectives, and not only being carried away by your own emotions to that, you know, experience or what has happened to a person, so forth, but be able to transcend that and look beyond it and actually try to seek and discover if there is a meaning behind that.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, this is an excellent discussion. I certainly want to continue this. We're kind of out of time for this segment. But before, Jack, we finish off here, I want you to do two things for us. Of course, first of all, tell us about your blog, either all of them or just the Brave New World Order. And I want you also to talk about your artwork, because you have a different blog with you know, t-shirts and merchandise and so forth, in regards to the excellent and beautiful artwork that you have been, you know, developing. And I think it's just wonderful, and I want, you know, people to know how they can get that and support your work, of course.
Okay. Well, my blog is The Brave New World Order, and you can get links to all my other blogs and my artwork, etc., at thebravenewworldorder.blogspot.com. And yeah, I've got all my drawings up. There's a link to view all my drawings. I try and do a drawing per post, just to sort of an overview of all the elements in the blog. In the blog posts, I'll try and combine them into one piece to sort of help as a visual guide to it. And I've also just recently put up the opportunity for people who are interested to buy t-shirts and my original artwork to help support my work if they want to do that and if they like the work. And I've been drawing for years, and it's another way I've found to incorporate my skills into, you know, getting my word out there. So
yeah. And I think it's beautiful. Do continue your artwork. It's magnificent. So everyone, do check it out. TheBraveNewWorldOrder.blogspot.com. And we will continue with Jake in the subscriber section now. But we will take a short break, and we will be right back. We are going to continue talking with Jake Kutsey for our subscribers now. We are going to dive deeper into Jake's work and his interpretations of the 9/11 event, some of his new work on that, and also get into some of his video material. The destruction of the Solomon's Brothers building, or World Trade Center Building 7, and the new Freedom Tower is something that we'll also get into, and the completion of that, of course, in 2012. We'll also get into some excellent stuff about symbolism, the octagon, and the connection with the Great Pyramids, and a whole lot more. So do join us in the subscriber section. If you're currently not subscribing and are interested in doing so, either click on subscribe on our front page at redicecreations.com, or on sign up if you're in our radio section or our radio archive. If you like what we do here, this is the best way to help and support this radio show. And for you guys who don't have a credit card or don't want to use PayPal, check out our alternative payment methods. You don't need a credit card to sign up. Thank you for tuning into the program, and thanks to producer Fredrik Palmgren. We will be back on Sunday with Kent from the Kentroversy Papers, dissecting Hillary Clinton and a whole lot more. So heads up on that, this is Henrik Palmgren. We will speak soon. Take care.
Starts falling from the sky.